wrote a memo that was circulated in late 2024, and it was published in 2025. You talked about this would be the year of greatness for Reality Labs, a time determining whether the metaverse would go down as the work of visionaries or a legendary misadventure. We're about halfway through the year. Where are you on that trade-off between the visionary outlook and the misadventurehood?
Yeah, history has its eyes on us, so to speak. I don't know if we'll judge it at the end of this year, we'll judge at the end of the decade, but this does feel like the pivotal year. The thing that so many people get wrong is we tend to think of years as interchangeable. We're like, yep, every year, you just like turn the crank, you get one unit of work, it's all equivalent, and it may average out, but it is definitely not the case that every year is of equivalent opportunity or value. Some years in a decade are just worth more than other years for environmental reasons, for competitive reasons, for technological reasons. Coming into this year, we knew. We've done a couple of interesting things. We'd broken through with the Ray-Ban Meta AI glasses. Yeah. It's a convergence of two different investments of ours coming together in a way that was not just exciting to consumers, it's exciting to our competitors. So suddenly, we go from toiling in the relative obscurity to being very much in the world with a product that is very attractive to consumers and thus competitors. So your window, the clock has started on competition coming. And that just means that the progress we make in this year is of disproportionate value to any year before or after it closes. And so I really wanted to impress upon, especially some of my younger engineers, for whom they're like, oh yeah, cool, this is like another year in the career. This might be the biggest one. You might 5-6 years from now look back and be like, man, that was the year. I should have cranked hard in that year. And we've had years like that before. 2008 was a crazy year for us at Facebook, and there was the downturn, and there was also an opportunity that came with that. So we've had crazy years, and I look back, and they weren't all of equal value. And the amount of work I put into those special years had disproportionate impact on the ones that followed.
What do you need to see by the end of this year to help you answer that question to determine whether this was make and not break?
Yeah, the way this will be judged in the limit of time is always the market. The market is always the determining factor. Do people adopt the technology or do they not? And that is what ultimately will drive competitors and industries to standardize or formalize around those things. The market is actually, especially when it comes to hardware, a trailing indicator. So you look for early indicators. To some degree, you do have to have a level of confidence and taste in-house. This is something I learned from Sheryl Sandberg. You know, Sheryl used to always talk about most companies don't fail because they got beaten by a competitor. Most companies fail because they didn't execute their own plan correctly. And so what I try to do with the team is really focus us not so much on the competitive landscape as on are we executing to our standards? And so we have a set of ambitious plans for the year. Right now we're on track, but admittedly a lot of these plans are kind of back weighted, especially some of these research programs are yielding now. So what we'll know by the end of the year is whether we executed on our plan or not. What we'll know in 5 years' time is whether that was enough.